Dear friends, today we are trying to realize the power of inheritance by writing a small program. Today we need to develop a program to produce payslip of an employee. We need to include employee name, employee code and designation inside a class. Then we are going to create another class that contains details such as account number, date of joining and basic pay. Then we will create one more class containing other pay elements such as provident fund, life insurance and tax. So essentially we are going to create three different classes, but each class derive from one another. Now we will first create employee class. You can give any meaningful name. So by looking at data member's employee name, code and designation, you may think it is an employee and you may give employee as a class name. Then another class which contains account number, date of joining and pay, basic pay details. So let us say it is employee pay. Then one more class that should contain other pay elements such as provident fund, life insurance and tax information. So let us call it as employee salary. So now you have three classes. Then we may have one more class, the program's main class, that class, if you include, you will have four class, one main class. Now it is time to figure out which data members or properties and the methods which should be inside these classes. How can we decide that? Looking at the question, you can easily guess what are the data members or the properties that should be included inside these classes, such as name, code, designation, joining date, basic pay, PF. These are possible properties inside these classes. But what about the methods? They have not given any information about the methods required. By looking at the question, you may be able to think we need to take inputs for name, code, designation, pay informations, right? You are right. Now we need to read information for all this information, and after computing the different pay elements, we need to display back, or we need to show those details back. Hence, we can assume that we need to have methods for reading and showing. Now we have got a plan. So let's start writing this program. First, the employee class. Employee class is to contain properties such as name, designation and code. You can assume all these are strings. And the next class that we called employee pay contains members such as account number, basic salary or basic pay and the joining date. You can assume different data types such as account number is an integer, basic pay, you can say it is double data type. It is not the most accurate for the real purpose or realistic application development. Double data type may not be sufficient, but for our application that is more than enough. So we'll take double data type. And joining date, you have dedicated date types, however we can assume string for now. Then the next class, which we called employee salary, should contain all other details such as DA, HRA, gross, provident fund, life insurance premium, tax, net, so on. Here DA means dearness allowance, HRA house rent allowance. If you add all here, you can see two parts. One are income components, another are expenditure or deductible. So here dearness allowance and house rent allowance, they will be computed on the basic pay and they will be added to the salary. However, provident fund, life insurance and tax, they should be deducted from the salary. If you add different incoming elements, you will get the gross salary. If you add the outgoing elements or the deductibles, you will get the net salary. You need to deduct these deductions from the gross salary. So you need to do all these computations inside this employee salary class. So for now, we are just writing the data members or the properties here, and hence this class is complete now. We may need to create one more class because we need to create objects of employee class and we need to use them, right? For that, next class, I will name it as employee pay A2. This is the experiment name. And inside this class, we are going to have main method. This class is made public because this class contains main method, and my file name and this class name will be the same. We will not write any methods in this iteration of writing. Hence, we will just leave it blank. So now, we will fill them, fill all these details a bit later. Now, you may wonder why all these are isolated classes. These classes are not connected to each other. But we need to derive this class from employee class. Otherwise, just holding account number, basic and joining date may not make much sense without name, designation and employee code information. Hence, we need to derive this class from the employee class. For that, we write employee pay extends employee. If employee pay extends employee, then all the properties and methods of employee class will be available to employee pay. Similarly, employee salary should be derived from employee pay. For that, we write employee salary extends employee pay. Now, you will get members of employee pay class inside employee pay employee salary class. Not just that, you will also get the members of employee. So in this class, employee salary, you will get name, designation, code, account number, basic, joining date, along with the members DA, HRA, gross, PF, LIC, tax and net inside employee salary. So you can access all the members which you can see here inside this class. If you add methods in employee class, if they are not private, they will be available in employee pay. And the methods inside employee pay, if they are not private, they will be available in employee salary. And hence, you may access most of the methods included in employee and employee pay in employee salary class. So now, let's add few methods. Now let's guess which methods we need inside employee class. As the data members are just string, we may not be able to do any computations, but we need the input. We do need for name, designation and code, employee code. So hence we need a method for reading information. Let us call it as read. And also we need a method for displaying that information back. Let us call it as show. And hence we have two methods inside employee class. For now, we will keep these methods empty. Later we will fill what is required inside these methods. Now let us move to employee pay class. Which methods might be essential for these elements? Again, here we have account number, basic and joining date, we may not be able to do computations and store results with these members. But we do need to take inputs and we need to show the output. For that, again, we will have these two methods. You can use the same name, hence I will just copy paste these things. Now let us focus on employee salary. To consider the elements of employee salary class, the properties DA, HRA, gross, provident fund, life insurance component, tax, and net salary. Here, none of the data elements or the properties are read from the user input. User is not providing all these components, but we are need to compute these elements. As we are computing these elements, we may not require any input methods inside employee class. I mean employee salary class. So which method we may need to do? We need to do the computations, right? For that, we may include a method called compute. You may give any meaningful name. I will write it as compute. Then we need to display the results. After the computation, we need to display the results, right? Hence, one another method. Let me call it as show. And here we are. So now, as you can see, we have written empty methods for all the classes. Oh, wait, we have forgotten one class, that is employee pay A2, the main method class. Inside this class, we need to write main method, right? Let us write that. Let us write public static void main with string arguments. So here we are. Now we have written methods for each class, but they are empty. They have just open and closing parentheses. Now we need to fill the required instructions inside each methods. Now let's start with employee class. We'll check what are methods are inside here and what instructions we may need to give. So what we should do inside read method of employee class? We should display an appropriate method message for the user to enter name, designation, and employee code. And then we should read each input for name and name designation and code. So for that, we will write code. And to read the input, we may need to use the scanner class. So let us write. So we create a scanner named scan, and then we will connect it to system input stream. We will display a message to enter different components, and we will read each components using a scanner dot next line method. As you can see here, we have used scanner, but for that we need to import the scanner from Java util package. We will put that statement on the top. Now, what about show method? We need to show the values of name, designation, and employee code. For that, let us add few statements here. Employee details, code, name, and designation. Now we can say that employee class is complete. We have added properties and methods and the method body. Let's get into employee pay now. Here we have again read method and show method. As you can guess, we need to read values for account number, basic, and joining date. For that, let's create a scanner and write a message, a request message to user, and then we'll use the scanner to read values for each of this. First, to invoke, as this employee pay is derived from employee class, first we need to invoke super.read. What it will do? It will invoke read method of this super class. So here employee code, name and designation will be read. After that we are creating a scanner here, and then we are requesting to enter date of joining, account number and basic pay. Then we will read each of the information, joining date as a string and account number as an integer and basic as a double. What to put in show method again, as you saw in the read method, first we need to invoke super dot, here it was read, here it should be super dot show to display values of employee code, name and designation. When you say super, it is super class. Without writing super keyword also we can say just read or just show, but that would be the name is reused here inside the class also, right? And hence if you just say read, this method will be invoked, that will be a recursion, and hence to avoid that we will add super. So super keyword will be used here also. We will do the same thing. First super dot show, then we'll display employee pay particulars, date of joining, account number and basic pay here using print line statement. As employee pay is looking complete now, let's move on to employee salary. Here we don't have a read method, but we have a compute. So here to compute DAHRA or any other components, and there are no criterions given here in the question, and hence we will assume some numbers or some proportionate values to these salary components, some of the salary components, like let's assume DA is 20% of basic. 20% you can say 20 by 100 or 0.2. likewise we will calculate each component. For gross we need to add DAHRA. For net salary, we need to deduct PF, LIC and tax from gross salary. So let's do that. So as you can see here, DAHRA is computed as some percentage of basic salary. Here, basic is not available in employee salary class, but it is available in employee pay class. So this basic property of employee pay is available in employee salary, because employee salary is derived from employee pay. Hence, non-private members of employee pay are available in employee salary. Hence, we have used basic here and we have computed DAHRA. By adding DAHRA to basic, we have computed gross, and then from some percentage of actually PF, LIC, tax can be computed from as a percentage of gross or as a percentage of basic as it has been given, but here we are just computing it on gross and then we are reducing it from the gross salary. So this will give you net salary. Now what we should do, we need to display all these components, right? So again, while displaying, first we should invoke super class show method to show all the information such as the employee details, code name, designation and then joining date, account number and basic pay. After that we should display these salary particulars. So let's do that. So I have added code to display these components. As you can see, DRNS allowance, house rent allowance, gross salary, provident fund, life insurance, income tax and net salary payable are displayed here. And this makes employee salary class complete. Now what we should do? We are supposed to create an object. So here there is no particular method given, but however, as you can see in the question, we need to prepare and produce payslip of an employee. So to produce a complete payslip, you need to use employee salary class, right? Because all these computations will happen inside this class. Hence, we will use this class to create an object here in the main class. This will be very simple. We will just create an object and then we will invoke all the methods. What all methods? First, we need to give inputs for that read method, and then we should compute all the components for that compute method, and then to show all the computed values, show method. Let's add it. Employee.read, employee.compute, employee.show. Here, employee in this EMP is an object. This is a reference variable for an object of employee salary class. An object, a new object is assigned to employee EMP variable, and hence if you execute these methods, it will be affected, and appropriate actions will be taken from all these different classes. So this is about the today's discussion. Thank you for watching. Take care and see you.